Good afternoon to everyone. I pay my gratitude to the Alumni Association of KGMU for giving me the opportunity to present in front of my respected mentors and the dear colleagues. I joined the institution in 1987. Currently, I am working at CDER, All India Institute of Medical Sciences, New Delhi. Today, I will discuss about the implants in rehabilitation of the facial defects. As we know, the face is the most conspicuous, unique, or aesthetically significant part of the body. Any individual's self-image and the self-esteem are affected or often dried by his or her own facial appearance, and any deviation in this feature requires special attentions. This defect can be ocular or vital, or may be related to the midfacial region involving the nose and the surrounding soft tissue, or maybe involving the ear or the auricle. They can be due to different type of the carcinomas in this region, and the, or maybe congenital in origin, infection due to infections or the trauma. In case of the trauma, it may be due to road traffic accident, sports, sharp objects, fire injury, or maybe due to chemical or the related to some industrial work or related to the workplace habits. In case of the facial defects, surgical reconstruction is always given preference over the prosthetic reconstruction because this appears as the to the individual as self or their own body part. But in case of the prosthetic reconstruction, the aesthetics is good. Even then, in certain cases, surgical reconstruction is not possible because of unavailability of the donor tissue when the defect is very large, or maybe contracture of the underlying tissues in case of burn injury, trauma injury, or previous surgery, or maybe patient is not willing for multiple surgery, or patient medical condition is such multiple surgeries are not possible. But in case of prosthetic reconstruction, there are certain limitations also, like they require long-term maintenance because silicones has very short life. Like in our temperate climate, they survive for 1.5 year or to the 2 year only. Though these type of the prosthesis need removal during sleep and water sports, and because of their short shelf life, they require the recurring cost. Anyway, they appear as artificial to the patients. So we can retain these prosthesis with the help of the spectacles, adhesives, or the implants. In case of the spectacle retained prosthesis, marginal adaptation is compromised because the prosthesis is moved with the specs. But the adhesives, although they provide the good retention, but the retention is not reliable because due to the perspiration, sometimes prosthesis come out itself, and these adhesives are mainly affected in cases where defect is small. There should be a guideline for the orientation of the prosthesis, and underlying tissue should be not movable, and border should be large and healthy. But in cases where adhesive cannot be used, we can very well use implants because they provide the better retention. And as the retention is improved, so margin adaptation is good, so aesthetics is better, and patient comfort is also improved. And in case of adhesive, a patient has to apply the adhesive at each time and remove the prosthesis in the night and then apply in the morning. But in case of implant-retained prosthesis, this step is not required. So the life of the prosthesis increases, that lead to the psychological benefit to the patient. If we discuss about in which cases we can use the implants, we can use the implant in any of the cases, except in few conditions, like where the defect is very large, where we cannot use the adhesives, implant can be used very well. Where narrow margins, there are very few orientation beds, or some tissue undercuts are not present to retain the prosthesis, we can very well use the implants. For the facial defects, although any type of the implant can be used, but initially brain mark design implant, especially for the facial prosthesis, these implants have long neck, or the we can say flange into the crestal module, which have the holes that provide the stability to the implant as well as the bone growth through these holes, so that again aid in the osseointegration. So now we can use any implant which have some certain surface modifications to increase the surface area and available in shorter length. Over the implant, we can use different type of attachment like UCLA. We want to make the bar in the implant level prosthesis. But in cases where the soft tissue thickness is more, we can use multi-unit abutment. We call it UMA, universal multi-unit abutment. In this abutment, this part of the transmucosal part of the abutment become the part of the implant only. Over this, we can place UMA healing cap, and there is available UMA impression cap as well as the casting sleeve. And above this transmucosal attachment, we can use either locator or the ball attachment. So how to decide how many implants can be placed? That definitely depend on the size and shape of the prosthesis and the amount of forces which will be subjected to the prosthesis as well as on the implants. As in case of the facial prosthesis, they are subjected to very less amount of forces as compared to the intraoral implants. They have to bear the weight of the prosthesis as well as the force which are exerted at the time of the placement and removal of the prosthesis. And the forces exerted at this time is again depend on the stiffness or the retentiveness of the retentive elements, manual dexterity of the patient. These are the factors. Then again, we have to decide what type of the silicone we will use to construct these prostheses. Although different type of the silicones are available in the market, but for facial prostheses, we have to use medical grade prostheses. And again, in case of the medical grade silicones, there are HTV, room high temperature vulcanizing silicone, and the room temperature vulcanizing silicones. In these silicones, we prefer to use for facial prostheses RTV because they have good marginal strength as compared to HTV, and they have better translucency as compared to the HTV. In our institute, we use either Factor 2 or the Cosmosil. For the successful rehabilitation of these patients, multidisciplinary approach is required as the different people from the different specialty are required for the different steps, like prosthodont is required initially, later on radiologist, surgeon and anaplastologist is also required for the successful rehabilitation of these patients. So our goal in the rehabilitation of these patients is to achieve aesthetics which is acceptable to the patient, as well as so that the patient's confidence in himself or herself increases, that lead to enhancement in social reintegration as well as psychological rehabilitation to the patient. So that further lead to improvement in the quality of life of the patient. So how do we have to select a patient for this type of rehabilitation? We have to see the age of the patient. Age of the patient is affected in that way, like if we are planning for the auricular prosthesis, the mastoid growth is completed at the 8 year of age. So it's better to undergo for the implantation prosthesis when the patient attained the age when the growth of the mastoid is completed. Or maybe patient have any concurrent disease that might affect the osseointegration or affect the surgery. We have to see the overall physical condition, psychological status of the patient, and the perceive what type of the quality of life the patient is want. And again, we have to give the consideration what other treatment options which are available and can be used for this particular patient. So we should analyze in detail about the risk and the benefit of all the procedures. Then we have to select the one which is in the benefit of the patient, because anyway, patient welfare is of paramount importance for us. So while treatment planning is depend on the location of the defect, where the defect is located, how the defect has occur, what is the etiology, and how to we are going to reconstruct, are the autogenous or prosthetic, what material we use, and whether the tissue undercuts are present or not, or what type of the retentive elements we will use. All these affect the treatment planning for these patients. Now we'll explain with the help of the cases which we had done in our department, see how to what we can do in certain situations. Like this young girl has a history of her hair was struck in the fodder cutter. So her skin as well as the auricle was pulled out in the fodder cutter. So in this case, surgeon says surgical reconstruction or autogenous reconstruction is not possible due to the contracture of the skin. So patient was taken up for the prosthetic reconstruction. For the prosthetic reconstruction, we at first took the impression to make a diagnostic model over which we had made a radio. We at first placed the marks to position the implant where the implant can be positioned to retain the prosthesis, or what we can do as soon as patient reported to us, we can take the photograph of the patient, and with the help of those photographs or with the help of the CT data, we can make a positive of that, and over that we can flip over the either the opposite side or ear, or we can take the ear from the ear bank. Then we can see which one is suited for that particular patient. Then we can either do 3D printing for that ear, and that can be later on converted into the wax. And in the wax, we had placed here we had used a tin foil to use a radiopaque marker, or we can use gutta percha as a radiopaque marker. Then we ask the patient for CT scan. In the CT scan, we can evaluate the amount of bone available in relation to the radiographic markers, and then if required, we can change the position. Then the same template can be converted to the surgical template, and the implant placement procedure is although almost same as for the intraoral implant. But these implants can be placed either in local anesthesia or in the general anesthesia. General anesthesia and sutures is removed same in the 7 days. Then we have to ask the patient to clean the area, and then we leave the implant in that location for 3 to 6 months. After 6 months, we start the prosthetic procedure. We first do the stage 2 surgery, then after 1 week we can take the either implant level impression if we are using the implant level attachment, or if we are using the UMA type of the attachment, then we have to take the abutment level impression. Then on the impression, here in this case, this the cast was poor, over which we have attached the analog of the ball attachment, over which we had made the acrylic conformer. Then wax trial prosthesis was fabricated over it. This was tried in patient, and then we had done the wax trial is finalized. Then we had flasked it, and we had make a 3-piece mold. Here the 3-piece mold is very essential for auricular prosthesis because we want to preserve the mold. If we had not make 3-piece mold, then there will be two problems. One, we will be not able to do the characterization in the mold, and the other problem is we may torn the prosthesis while retrieving it, and anyway we will not able to preserve the mold for future packing, as these materials have very short shelf life. So it's better to make 3-piece mold. Then this is the raw prosthesis that we retrieve from the mold. We had place it on the patient face. Later on, we had finished this or remove all these irregularities, and then delivered it to the patient. There's the patient. Later on, patient has purchased 1 wig also to enhance the aesthetics. This is the another patient. This patient has a history of roadside accident in which he has lost his ear. And when male patient reported to us, implant was placed somewhere outside. And by history, we come to know that in this patient, any CT scan or previous planning was not done before the placement of the implant. So when we did place the impression post, just to see, take the impression, we find their angulation is not correct. So in this patient, we decided to make a bar type of the attachment. So impression was taken. Over this, we had made the bar and the... In this patient, we had made the bar in the titanium alloy because here the abutment we used was the implant level only. Only on this bar, we had followed all the steps. First, we had fabricated the acrylic conformer. Acrylic conformer is must be for the bonding of the silicon bonded to the acrylic. There is a gold primer to unite the silicons to the acrylic. So we had done the wax up like in the previous case. Wax trial was taken. It was confirmed. We have seen from the back also. Then 3-piece flasking was done. Silicon was packed, and this is the final ear which was delivered to the patient. This is the another patient who has reported a history of gunshot injury in which he has lost his one eye. This patient wanted implanted in prosthesis only. So before making a treatment planning for implanted in prosthesis, we make one interim adhesive retained prosthesis for this patient. So for the implanted in prosthesis, we first make a clear acrylic conformer. In this, we had placed the markers and CT scan was done. In the CT scan, what we noticed in this patient, there is the inferior orbital rim. The ideally in orbital defect, 3 implants must be placed, 2 in the superior orbital rim, 1 in the inferior orbital rim in the near to the distal canthus. But in this patient, there was no bone in the inferior orbital rim in the distal part, so implant placement was not possible. So only 2 implants were placed. One into the middle of the superior orbital rim, other is in the distal part of the or towards the outer canthus of the superior orbital rim. So after 6 months, what we noticed, the one implant which was placed into the superior part of the superior orbital rim was have a little angulation towards outside. Initially, we think we will use the magnets, but magnets use was not possible to make aesthetic prosthesis. So we again make a bar. While we make the bar, we had customized the bar so that we had used the magnets over the bar, and this was moved towards the base of the defect. And over this, we had make acrylic conformer. Then we do the wax up. Here, this is the wax up. This is the how the magnets were attached to the prosthesis. Later on, flasking and packing was done for this patient. This is the magnet visible into the undersurface of the eye. These are in the defect. Prosthesis were delivered and it was looking nice, and patient was happy with the prosthesis. This is another young female patient. In this patient have a very unfortunate injury as an acid burn. Someone has thrown acid on her face, so she has lost her one eye. This patient want to go somewhere outside the India for some type of bionic eye she had read from the internet. So she wanted us some interim prosthesis. So for this patient, we had planned for the spectacle retained prosthesis because she was going for some other type of the prosthesis. She was not willing even for the implant retained prosthesis. So we had took the impression for this patient, make the molars. Then we have to modify the conformer in this case. This is what I wanted to highlight. Like in previous case, we had made a complete conformer. In here, the defect was too shallow. So we had modified the conformer. All the rest of the procedure is same. And later on, we attached the prosthesis with the spectacles. Here we had attached the prosthesis with the spectacles, and eyelashes were added to the prosthesis. We can see here we have added the eyelashes, and the final prosthesis was delivered, and patient was happy after the complete characterization of the prosthesis. This is another patient. This patient has a history of glass cut injury. This young guy work in a factory where he dealt with the glass slabs. So while he was holding the glass slab from the over roof, one slab felt on his face and his nose was chopped off. So at that time, some surgeon has used the pedicle flap to construct the nose. But patient was very unhappy as this gave very ugly appearance to the patient. Patient reported to us for the fabrication of the nose. While examination, we find fabrication of nose in this situation is not possible. So we took the help of ENT surgeon to reposition this pedicle flap onto the forehead. They agree on the treatment plan. So they ask us to make an interim prosthesis. So we make acrylic nose attached to the spectacle that was once the surgery was performed, this nose was delivered to the patient. And for the oral defect, one interim partial denture was fabricated. And the exposed part of the forehead as well as the nasal area was covered with split thickness skin graft. This is after the healing. This we can see, this is the flap was repositioned. Here the healing is completed. Now this much defect, now his eye was completely open, patient was happy. So in this patient, initially we had planned for the placement of the 3 implants, but later on in the glabella bone was very less, so we were able to place only 2 implants in the pariform aperture After 6 months, implant were exposed, and then we had fabricated the prosthesis. Here is the little difference, because here the nose is triangular in cross section, and we were not able to place the implant in glabella. So a reverse bi-shaped framework was fabricated in titanium, over which two clips was used to retain, and then same as acrylic conformer was fabricated, wax up was done, and this is the final prosthesis which was delivered to the patient. Patient was quite happy with the final prosthesis, and we had make, as the, these patient I had explained, has to remove this prosthesis during night. So one acrylic stent was fabricated that patient can use during night, so while he remove his nose. And for the oral defect, fixed prosthesis was, tooth supported prosthesis was fabricated for this patient. This is one, another patient. This patient have a history of NK cell tumor, and after debridement of the tumor site, she has the defect in the premaxillary region as well as part of the nose, and the cheek was removed. So as the NK cell tumor has have a very poor prognosis, so in these cases the chances of recurrence are very high, so implants are not possible and not advisable also. So whenever there is a facial defect, if is an oral defect is present, and this is a combined defect, both are combined, so what we did, first make a intraoral prosthesis. Intraoral prosthesis with extension of the prosthesis, with extension of the prosthesis into the nasal defect area with the stitch. And once we had delivered this to the patient, we had make a wax up for the acrylic conformer. In this we had attached the stitch button. With the help of these stitch button are the same stitch button which we use in the clothing. And here how the conformer was stabilized onto the face. Then over that we had done the wax up like in the previous prosthesis. Wax up was finalized, prosthesis was packed, and this is the magnet under stitch button under, sorry, these are the stitch button on the undersurface of the acrylic conformer, and these are in the obturator. This is the final prosthesis. This is how it is retained onto the denture, and this is the final picture which we had delivered to the patient, the final prosthesis. This is about how to we had constructed and in what cases we can use the implants, in which cases we cannot use the implants. But once we deliver the prosthesis, work is not completed. We can say half of the work is still remaining. Maintenance part is very important. We have to educate the patient how to place the prosthesis, how to remove the prosthesis, and how to clean the prosthesis. These factors are very important to maintain the life of the prosthesis. And we have to emphasize the importance of the follow-up schedule, because many times these patients lost to follow-up. Then they will suddenly come after 2 years, 3 years, when their prosthesis get distorted or they lost their prosthesis sometime, only then they come. So we have to emphasize the importance of the follow-up so that life of the prosthesis can be maintained and we can see whether the patient is following the instruction completely or not. So timely manner we can improve or we can help the patient, as it is the God-given right to every human being to appear human. So we have to try to do our best to rehabilitate these patients. Thank you to everyone. Thank you.